Hello there, everybody, and welcome back to episode 34 of Firemind. So, things are pretty good, but I had to catch this one moment of wonder that I had when I checked back with my save file. So, our esteemed ex-lord has been taking out a giant wren. What really surprised me to see that our ex-lord Izum is definitely a biter, and he seems to like it. Jokes aside, he just took down one of them beasties, and I'm quite happy about that he did, but seriously, we need to talk about your combat style. You shouldn't do that too often, my friend. But the main topics for today, you know, we have always a main topic. I want to go for the real deal now. Thing with this area here is just simple. The Malachite Ridges, as I like to call them henceforth, are a nice project and all, but it is still something where we have to invest a lot of workforce, and pretty much we have accessed what we need. I mean, there is more copper to be excavated if we needed to. We can go, I think, downstairs a bit, exactly. We can build more bridges on these ridges and get it done and get that area excavated. But currently, I think the fort is in a very, very good shape. We are pretty much done with all the things that are necessary, and it is time to go for the big price. So we are going to get started today with the drop. So I call this the drop, as this will be our direct connection to the depths, to the horrible, horrible depths, directly down to the magma. This will be really one hell of a task now, as we have to dig this thing all the way downstairs to the center of the world, so to say. I'm not looking forward to that. So another giant wren is attacking one of our woodcutters. Why is this man actually so far out of here? And he died. One of my woodcutters died. That ain't fun. So these giant wrens, they really have turned into quite the pest here. So if I remember correctly, statues for these are being made. But I really feel not well about this elven scheme that we have to endure. They somehow must have enraged the animals. At least that's what would be happening if you'd be asking our Duchess and the Queen by now. So yeah, I really feel horrified about what we see there. So our bone doctor, ability to stand lost. Jeez. So we need to check back with our hospital. Something ain't right here. It's at least the assignments for the doctoring people are just not good. We can't have a bone doctor assigned who's not able to stand on his feet. Maybe he is not assigned at all. Maybe he's just a profession-wise a doctor. You never know. But we're just going to assign a couple of extra people here, just in case that we might need it, you know. There we go. Life in Firemind is taking its toll, bit by bit. The road somehow enrages the creatures of this place, but they have to just deal with it. All right. So for some reason, my excavation jobs are taking a little bit longer than before, but well, I don't know what they did there. Anyways, I'm going to let them complete their tomfoolery here. For some reason, that coffin hasn't been delivered either. Ah, here we go. So let's see. Are the statues of the giant wren already completed? No. I have ordered them. I can vaguely remember that, but they don't seem to be completed yet. All right. So we got to place down another coffin there. Going for the leaden ones for this hall. And you see they seem to be quite heavy. Problem is just I have to wait until they are really put down on the ground before I declare them to a tomb. Otherwise I get these nasty graphical bugs that I really hate. Okay, by now the excavator should be done on that end. So, let's see. The drop. So, let's go downstairs 10 levels and see what'll happen. Why is a carpenter fighting against that thing? Alright, so... the stockpile zone here seems to be the problem. So let's see if we can station or squad. And see if they can help our poor guy in need. Oh, dang it. So let's see. I'll be positioning some the standards of persuasion there and see how that'll go down. The brewer is fighting too. Alright. So as matters stand, I think that must be the end of the, of that thing. And off goes the head. I think we're done with that bugger. Okay. So life in Firemind is turning more and more dangerous. Not gonna lie, there's, so many reports of people being attacked by wild animals. It's really unsettling. It's really about time that we, put an end to these elven, empires there. So if it goes down, if you go, alongside with the, thoughts of war, dwarves, they are pretty sure that it's all the elves to blame. I mean, they're enraging the animals. It's clearly what's happening here. Probably they are the ones to blame that these damn buggers are so large to begin with. Probably too. So the drop will be a real painstaking construction, not gonna lie. But we have to deal with this. So the queen demands leggings, and we shall deliver. So let's start with just a couple of fine leather leggings. And I have to check back with the queen's apartments. Something is just wrong there. So her bedroom isn't bedroomy enough still? Yeah? Alright. So obviously she wants a statue of Ozol in her room so desperately. It's just not complete without the Duchess. So am I going to go for a good one here? Let's see. These aren't that good. This one is good. I really got to pay attention to the statue makers more, as I see that they are creating quite some crappy things. Ah, well, specialization in this game is amazing. All right, have I? Okay. So when we're constructing the drop. We have to stop the assignments like that. This just doesn't work. It's okay that the stonecutters are doing the smoothing jobs in the city exclusively, but when it comes down to the construction of one mega thing there, we just have to employ the entirety of the fort. The real bummer here will be that I still have not fully figured out how I will be building the actual pump stack. So we're starting just with the minimal footprint of the pump stack for starters. Ooh, a doctor is taken by a fey mood. And we're going to expand from that point on. I really hope it'll work out somehow, because I think it will be really a horrible thing otherwise. So, obviously our woodcutter friend that died on the hilltop there hasn't been even found by his friends yet. What a tragedy. Alright. Construction of the drop is also obviously not going on that quickly. It keeps my miners that busy these days. Maybe we need more of them. Well, the worst part will be just excavating my way through the starned aquifer. Once we're done with that, things will actually get a lot easier because we're just going to drill away straight down to the center there. I have triangulated this place. So if we go down there, you'll see nothing is in our way. All the way down. It's quite a way down. Wait a sec, did I? Oh no. Did I just? Okay. So good thing that I did check on that. So these commands can be erased. That part of the drop is not good enough. Oh dear. So we obviously have to be very precise here. Very, very so. So I'm gonna go for and make it from bottom to top, obviously. Jeez, I'm so happy that I double checked on that. This is one hell of an annoying task to do. So obviously here we are safe, and here we are as well. Okay. So let's see. Or next best area to work with is there, so we excavated like that. Okay, like I said, I'm quite relieved that we are walking the extra mile here. So, okay, we need to pass through this area here. Something is horrible again. Okay, so let's say this will be it. Alert! The woodcutter has been found dead. Okay. So, constructing the drop will be a massive undertaking. Because the big problem to me is that every mistake will be really punished quite severely. Alright, what does our friend Dubar Colaxis create? He's a legendary gem setter already, so looks like he has come down to create his magnum opus. Like the idea of that. All right. So, I know what I'm doing here. We're going to be ordering 10 new copper picks, and we're going to assign a couple of extra people there. As I really feel as if we are struggling with with the fulfillment there. So, here we go. Gonna check back with my friend from time to time to make sure he got everything he needs. All right. So, this construction here is only one part of the entire deal. I want to get started with adamantine mining in the upcoming episodes as well, but one thing at a time. We have a ton of clear glass at our disposal, so we will be absolutely easily capable of doing the proper excavation routine, and a quite safe one at that. So yeah, I think we should be really fine at this end. So, let's see. I don't think... Let's see. I don't want it 5 wide so far. So, let's make it 4 wide and expand it as needed. So, let's drive this thing home. Let's see if it'll work out. Okay, so far so good. These need to be constructed. Ugh. Let's see, is that parallel? Yes, it is. And now we can't go upstairs. I really hope it'll work out. There it goes. Okay, so yeah, this'll probably take a while. Let's get back to the gem jewelers guild. And he's lacking something. All right, let's check with that. Rock blocks, metal bars, rock, 10 hide, silk cloth. All right, so our friend is lacking silk cloth. That should be doable. So step one, Sudel Paged Peaks. Well, must have had a run-in with some local monstersies. So we got to collect webs as the very most important thing. I mean, the commands that I gave, they are pretty easy to follow. Not gonna lie. Probably need to set up a proper clothes industry one day soon. Tell you what I see here is, for me, an alarming thing, so we should probably set up a couple of extra looms. Something like that. So yeah, of course they are stopping their work because of the whetstone incidents. That was absolutely expected. Alright. Closely monitoring this one. So we obviously ran out of spider silk. Let's see. Maybe we can check it out like that. Collect webs. There we go. So, Logum. Let's follow Logum Silver Destined on his adventures to save our jeweler. It would be really, really tragic if we'd be losing him. And as we see here, our man Logum, or Lady Logum. Why is she walking that long? There's webs everywhere. It has to be one very specific web, obviously. Sheesh. No wonder it's taken that long. Alright, so she finally got what she needed. I'm very concerned about the well-being of him. So she is a legendary weaver, though, so we must trust her judgment that this was just the right thing for an artifact. Let's just hope she makes it home before our gem setter goes crazy. That would be really a tragic loss for the fort, because I have only one of these. So I'm very, very, concerned about this one, but she made it now, and generally we can now, well, we can now check out how good my how well my logistics network is networking. All right, so she's taking the climb and we have another request here. I'm just gonna using that to monitor how my logistics are actually working out. So now she's taking that climb. Getting back to that climb. Alright. It's quite a, it is quite a walking time from the caverns up to our workshops. This is by no means even close to any form of efficiency. This is quite bad. Alright, there she goes. Okay, and now weave that thread into silk, as it is really the most important thing in the fort right now. So another giant wren is attacking one of us. This time just outside of the fort. These darn beasts, they don't know any shame or whatever anymore. They just attack us directly and on our premises. So another pair of leggings has been ordered, and we eagerly provide. I'm gonna roll with the leather leggings for now. Okay. Let's see if our jeweler friend has enough here or not. So this is our legendary gem setter picking up his thing. We go back to this workshop. Meanwhile, the construction of the drop seems to go forward quite excellent. And what's also quite a relief to me is to see that Dolbar Call Axis seems to just on his way to do his thing. So more dampstone located. Okay, so let's get back to the drop. We have worked our way all the way upstairs like that. So far things worked out really smoothly. There's even Topaz. The really worst part about all this is that we're probably going to need to deconstruct all of these staircases at some day in the future. This will be quite a nightmarish construction. But let's see. Okay. Because, you know, where the place where the staircases are right now, as a matter of fact, we are wanting to create ourselves their, what's it called? That's where the pump stack should be standing at. So you can't put a pump stack where a thingy is at. Okay, so obviously they proactively punched their way through the aquifer. I second that. I mean, who needs safety, right? Awesome. They are such gigachats. We're just going to smooth out the area there once it's excavated completely. And the caravan has arrived. Okay, and Dobar Kolaxis has started his mysterious construction. Very, very good news. Very, very, very good news. So Uzul wants her bracelets again. And there's still not enough fancy in that room, yeah. Looks like the queen is still unhappy. I have to check back with that. How much wealth does this bedroom need? Seriously. All right. I mean, there's more Uzul where that came from, so meh. I'm not the one to judge. Alrighty, but the good part here is that finally the caravan from the old capital, from or is Erdem Anum or faction in Dwarvish. I don't know yet, but we'll see about that. Another thing that is on my to-do list here, very, very important, some statues for the tavern. These have been requested on the Discord quite a passionate request, just like flooring this area here, but this has to wait a wee bit longer. Please be with me. When I do the flooring here, I want to do it correctly, and that means I have to rip out all the parts here too. And well, let's start with that main corridor though, because I want to check if marble blocks are doing the thing. Do I not have any marble blocks? Are you kidding me? I should totally have marble blocks. So, game, what is wrong here? Why are you fooling around with me like that? There is marble. Maybe I did a typo, I don't know. So, yeah. If I'll stick with that design, I'll have to use marble all the way though, so. Merchants have arrived, unloading their goods. They come with big bad wagons, and they obviously come this time from a different place. Damn, I wanted to check where they come from, but whatever. It works, that's the most important part for now. So we are very, very excited this year, as this is setting up the mark for DF hack, move trade goods. What? Whoa, I need to check with that menu another day. That looks badass and useful, but I really don't get it through like that. Ah yeah, here we can sort them according to their value. That's been what I've been after. So we're bringing the gem bins. I know I could trade just simply with what's it called again? Just with the lavish meals. A lot of people use these. I don't judge ever anybody who uses these, but for a roleplay run, I prefer to go for real goods and things that have a substantial value. You can by all means just do the Dwarven Delicacy Express. I don't judge either, but I find it rather weird to do this. Alrighty, so our broker is still sleeping. So I'd say I'll be using that time while the broker is still sleeping to issue a couple of smoothing jobs. So yeah, all that liquid in motion to start to make my FPS straggle along a tad bit. I do notice that the FPS is a tad bit worse than it was a while before. So you don't get to see where... Oh god, this is annoying. Alright, so we have to guess, or... Jeez, I hate that. Well, I think everywhere where there's conglomerate, we can safely say that we need that smoothing. I paused the game now, by the way, because I want to make sure that this part is working out as intended. So, yeah, if we are super unlucky, we have to deconstruct all of these stairs at some point. I don't know. I mean, I cannot construct a pump stack on that footprint here, but I also would need a massive maintenance undertaking on the same site. I still have no clue how I am going to go through such a massive amount of mountain, construct a pump stack in there without going crazy. But I think the trick in all that is that the ramps that we're gonna be putting in will be actually doing the trick, but I am afraid that this will be not enough. I'm afraid we will be needing more than that, but for starters, we're going to go there. I think in the long run, we're going to need... Ooh, all right. A Claro Opal figurine. So tell you what we're going to do, since the trader is still waiting, letting the guy wait. We're going to create ourselves a pedestal. Gonna put that thingy on the queen's room. She's still not happy with the severity of things there, so she needs more. All right, so let's check with the trader as soon as my broker is finally arriving. So it seems as if that caravan really did something to my FPS. Things are running way slower now. Where's my trader? I think that's my trader. This is looking good. Okay. They're still unloading. So, and I thought we would be late to the party. Okay. Well, I mean, on the other hand, we went through with that thing really quick. Carving our way through this thing was really not hard at all. We are currently seeing a little bit of an overflow of water here. But in all honesty, yeah, here, that's why. Because there's, no, that's just the stuff flowing through. Never mind. So, let's see. Just double checking now if I have missed another aquiferous layer in between. But no. The drip should stop very soon, as we now have made sure that these things are working out as intended. So yeah, I don't know what these guys are still doing, but they're still unloading. Wow. Looks like we gotta wait for the next episode for that, huh? I see there's somebody with this. Ah, look at these. There's a couple of mules arriving. Probably these are finally the last ones. So yeah, the caravan really had a lot of stuff on them, so we're going to wait until the next episode to see what's on that caravan. And I want to say thanks for watching. It's been my pleasure. We're going to continue next episode. I'm going to put that pedestal into the queen's quarters real quick. Oh, wait a sec. The statue hasn't been delivered either. Hmm. So maybe we should put the display somewhere else, but yeah. Either way, my good friends, leave me your comments down below. I'm all eager to hear back from you. And of course, as usual, leave a thumbs up for the algorithm. It would be deeply appreciated. And while I'm at it, all of those of you who are watching the series, let me know. I'm considering of setting back the episode numbers to 1 when we're starting to go for the adamantine mining and the real deep stuff. Let me know what you think. I think this is a pretty good start for season 6 as things are kicking into motion there for real. But that was just a bit of a thought that I had in between. Either way, leave a subscription if you haven't done so already. There's also in the description box all the links to the rest of the series. I'd be really happy if you'd give them a look. And also check with Patreon, PayPal, and Buy Me a Coffee. These are the best ways and means to support the channel, and I'd be deeply delighted if you'd give them a look. Big, big thanks to all of you who already did, and of course, as usual, a big, big thanks to you watching this video up until the very end. I deeply, deeply appreciate, and I hope you had a great time and you'll have a good day as well. See you there. Bye-bye.